अस्सलाम वालेकुम बॉयज, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर साउंड। अर्लियर वी हैव डन सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन एंड वेव मोशन। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज साउंड। एंड सब टॉपिक ऑफ साउंड इज साउंड वेव्स। SLOs ऑफ दिस टॉपिक आर एक्सप्लेन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ साउंड वेव्स। And second SLO is describe the longitudinal nature of sound waves. Production of sound waves. How can we produce sound waves? As we know that sound is a form of energy that travels from one place to another place in the form of waves. And all sounds are produced by the vibrating bodies. That means sounds need three things. First is vibrating body, second is medium, and third is receiver. Sounds are longitudinal waves and it requires mechanical medium. That means without any medium, sound cannot travel. Sound always needs a medium, mechanical medium. Sound waves consist of compressions and rarefactions. Because sound waves are longitudinal waves, so it has compressions and rarefactions. The area with high pressure is called compressions, and the area with low pressure is called rarefaction. As we told you, sounds is produced by a vibrating body. So examples of these are: a string vibrates to produce a tune, vocal cord vibrate to produce a sound, and another example is vibrating prongs of a tuning fork. The speed of sound in solid is faster than liquid and air. And the speed of sound in air is 343 meter per second and at one atmospheric pressure. The speed varies with temperature and humidity. That means these are the factors on which speed of sound varies. If the temperature is high, the speed of sound is high. If the air is humid, the speed of sound is also high. To find the speed of sound, we need the equation V is equals to F lambda, because sound is a waves. So we use this formula to find the speed of sound. Sound is produced by vibrating body. For example, if we hit the tuning fork with a rubber pad, it vibrates and produces sound. To prove that the tuning fork is vibrate, we touch it with a tennis ball and the ball moves away, which shows that the tuning fork is vibrate and it produces sound. Another example is, you see the drum. When we hit the drum, the membrane of the drum vibrates and producing sound. Second example, when we play a guitar, the string, the movement of the string to and fro motion, and it also produces sound. The third example is, sound is produced by vibrating prong of tuning fork. When we hit the tuning fork with the rubber pad, it vibrates and producing sound. Second thing is, sound needs medium to travel. That is why sounds are mechanical wave. In this diagram, you see a bell jar in which an electric bell hangs. When we switch on the bell, it rings and we listen that sound. But if we pump out the air from the bell jar, the sound dies. We can't hear the sound. This shows that sound needs or requires a medium, that is air, to travel. Describe the longitudinal nature of sound wave. This is our Second SLO. As we know that sound is an example of longitudinal waves, it consists of compressions and rarefactions. You see the examples of the tuning fork. When we hit the tuning fork, it vibrates, and when it moves to the right, compression occurs, and when it moves to the left, rarefaction occurs. The series of compression and rarefaction you see in the diagram. If you plot the graph, the compression is the crust shows the compressions, and the trough shows the rarefaction. Illustration of longitudinal waves of vibrating tuning fork in the air. Compressions are places where air pressure is slightly higher than the surroundings, and the rarefactions are the regions where the air pressure is lower than the surrounding. In the given figure, you see the direction of the propagation of the sound waves is along the direction of the oscillating air molecules. That is why we say that sounds are the longitudinal nature. The distance between two consecutive compressions and rarefactions is wavelength. You see, C stands for compression and R stands for rarefaction. The distance between the two compressions is called wavelength. Similarly, the distance between two rarefaction is also called a wavelength. All right, boys, I know you can understand both the SLOs. Thank you.